Hello classics, we were doing the chapter the early Vedic age and today we will continue with it. This is the third video on the chapter. And so far what we have learned, that a semi-nomadic tribal pastoralist people, they had come from Central Asia, they had entered India around 1500 BC and they settled in the northwestern part of India, that is in the Saptasindhu region. They had brought with them the language, the Sanskrit, and they called themselves the Aryans. And we also know that the Vedas are the main sect or the sacred text of the Aryans. They had all the information that we have about the Vedic, about this people or about the period which came to be known as the Vedic age is from the Vedas. Along with the Vedas, there are the Brahmanas, the Aryanas, the Upanishads, the Sutras, the Puranas, and the epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata. All these are the sources of information. The oldest Veda is the Rig Veda. There are actually four Vedas. The oldest one is the Rig Veda. And the Rig Veda is the main source of information about the early Vedic age, that is the period from 1500 to 1000 BCE. And as Rig Veda is the main source of information, so this period is also known as the Rig Vedic age or the Rig Vedic period. And we know that they had settled in the Saptasindhu region. We have started with their family social life. We know that the society was patriarchal. The head of the family was called the Grihapati. He was the eldest male member. Though the male members were given more importance, there are hymns in the Rig Veda that are talking about the brave sons. Along with that, we find that women enjoyed an important position in the society. They were treated equally with men. They were given education. They had, there were some women scholars who composed the Vedas. They took part in philosophical discussions. They could even select their husbands. The age of marriage for the girls was quite high, around 16 or 17 years. Child marriage was not known, and widows were also allowed to remarry. So that was about the family and the position of women in the society. And today we will learn about the dress and food and the recreation of the early Vedic period. Now about dress and food, we see that the Aryans, they used to wear two garments, the upper and the lower garment, and they used unstitched piece of cloth. That is, they didn't know how to stitch the cloth and make a dress out of it. They used to cover the upper part of the lower part of the body with unstitched piece of cloth. And both men and women, they wore jewelry made of gold, silver and precious stones. That was about their dress. What do we know about their food habit? About their food, we know that the Aryans, they ate very simple and healthy food, which mainly comprised of wheat, barley, maize, fruits and vegetables. Milk and milk products was also consumed by them. They also took intoxicating drinks like soma and sura, and meat was something that was eaten occasionally. So that was about their dress and food. Next we come to recreation. That is, what did the people do when they had free time, when they were not working? What did the Aryans do? We find out that the Aryans were fond of chariot racing and hunting. This was quite common in the society. They also enjoyed music, dance and gambling. This was the recreation, that is, for recreation. They used to either go for hunting or chariot racing. They loved to listen to music, or they enjoyed music, dance and also gambling. Next we come to one of the most important feature of the early Vedic society, that is the Varna system. What is this Varna system? The fourfold division of the society was known as the Varna system. The society in the early Vedic age was divided into four groups or classes. That was known as the Varna system. What were the four classes? The Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Sudras. Who were the Brahmanas? The Brahmanas were those group of people who had got education. They were educated, they gave in or imparted education, and they also were the ones who used to perform the religious practices. That means the Brahmanas were the priestly class in the society. They consisted of the priests, that is those people who was who used to do the worship, or they were associated with religious things. They were the ones who gave education to the others. So that was the Brahmanas. The second Varna in the society was that of the Kshatriya. Who were the Kshatriya Devis? This was the warrior class. That is the class of people who used to fight and protect the people from foreign attacks. They were the Kshatriyas. Next we have the Vaishyas. That is the merchants or farmers, those people who were engaged in economic activities like that of trading, trade and commerce or other kinds of economic occupations. They belong to the Vaishyas class. The last varna in the society was the Shudras. The Shudras were the people or the group of people whose work was to serve the upper class. So this was the fourfold division of the society in the early Vedic age, which came to be known as the Varna system. But this fourfold division was not based on birth. It was based on occupation, that is the occupation that was carried out by the person. According to it, he was given the position in the society. If he was the one who was doing the religious work, one who was giving the education, then he came under the Brahmanas. If he was one who is a warrior, who is a soldier, who is fighting to protect the people from the foreign attacks, then he comes under the Kshatriyas. Those who were doing other kinds of economic activities like that of trade and commerce or other economic activities like artisans and everything, farmers, they came under the Vaishyas. And Sudras were the last varna in the society who used to serve the other classes, that is the upper classes. This was not based on birth, it was based on occupation, and it was very flexible. That means there was interchanging of the varnas. As this was based on occupation, people could change his varna according to the occupation that he followed. But in the later Vedic age, we find that this no longer remains the same. There some changes took place in the varna system. What were those changes? We will learn about it in the when we will do later Vedic age. But for early Vedic age, we know that this was the fourfold division of the society, which was not based on birth, it was based on occupation, and it was flexible in nature, that is people could change their varna, and there were the four varnas were the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Sudras. The Brahmins were the ones who were the priestly class, Kshatriyas were the warrior class, Vaishyas were the merchants and traders and farmers, and Shudras were the class who used to serve the upper classes in the society. So that was the Varna system, and also we have learnt about recreation and the food habit of the people. Next we will take up the religious life of the people in the early Vedic age. In the early Vedic age, we find that the Aryans, they used to worship the forces of nature in the form of gods. This was something that you have already learned in the earlier chapters, that this practice was quite common, that is worshipping the forces of nature in the form of God. And we find that as the society was patriarchal, the most of the important gods, in fact all the important gods, they were all men. That is, the three important gods were Indra, that is the god of rain, Agni, Varun, Surya. Indra, Agni, Varun, these were the three gods. Then we have Surya, we have Vayu, Yama, we have female goddesses also. It was not that the goddesses were not there, female deities were not worshipped, they were also worshipped, but they were few in number, like that of Usha. Okay, so these were the main gods that they worshipped, and the important position was occupied by Indra, Agni and Varun. They were the three important gods in the early Vedic age. And the people believe, in the Rig Vedic period, people believed that all the gods, they were the different form of one supreme being. That is, there was one supreme being, or there was one supreme god, and from there the different forms of God have emerged. And the supreme god is the creator of the universe, that is the one who had created the universe is the supreme being. From him, the different gods are the different types of gods that they worship, they are the different forms of the same supreme being. And we also find that the people worshipped in the open air, chanting of hymns, because there were a lot of hymns in the Rig Veda that has been found. So chanting of hymns and making offerings to the god was very common, and they used to worship in the open air. And this worshipping of God, that is the religious activities, was done by the Brahmanas. They used to perform the yajnas or the sacrifices. So that was about their religious life, which was very simple. There were three important gods, that is Indra, Agni and Varun. There were other gods also, like Surya, or we have Vayu, they were also there. We also get the name of female goddesses like that of Usha, but the important gods were all men. People believed in the Rigvedic age that all the gods were the different forms of the one supreme being, that is the creator of the universe. They used to worship the god in the open air by chanting hymns and making offerings. And the Brahmins were the ones who were associated with these religious practices. They were the ones who used to perform the yajnas or the sacrifices. So we will keep up to this much, that is the religious life. In our next video, we will take up the next portion of the chapter. Thank you.